This is a short presentation, and after that I proceed to the project. So I don't have a title that you can see. So what is summer internship? So what do you think? It's just like a course, any other course that you take, right? So you have to ask questions, you get answers, right? Same. So have you understood? I mean, have you seen what is? I mean, you have tried asking these questions when you were actually doing a course, right? And then you keep on asking, right? You keep on asking. So then you understand. Towards the end of the course, you come to know what is programming, what is artificial intelligence. But before that, you have a very narrow or very vague idea of what that course is. It's very similar situation now, right? If you have done internship somewhere else, then you might understand, right? So can we ask what is what? So what does the dictionary meaning say then? Well, if we can ask so much, we can ask this also, right? So if you know this, then you know many other things, right? So what is it? So difficult to define. So this talk is actually, I spent 5 months or 6 months creating this talk. So it includes algebra, it includes formal logic, it includes system dynamics, and it includes something else which I don't remember. So it's like you want to define something, okay, you need some rules to define that. I mean, I think you have gone through such definitions wherein you know, we want to prove something, right? You did some already written axioms for that. But if you want to prove axioms, then you need a higher language, right? So then you have new axioms for that language, and then you have new axiom over here becomes a theorem in that language. So that's how it is. So it cannot be understood unless until, so the only way to understand is what is it is not what it is, right? And so it's not something else, then we know what it is. So particular object or anything. So it could be a concept, it could be anything. So the fundamentals of any language, you have 6 wives and 1 husband. So what, why, which, who? And these people used to fight all the time, you know. So the what, why would always ask what question. Likewise, why question, which question, okay. So all of them would fight. And then they would understand something. Anyway, there's no story like that. I tried creating it myself. So what do we finally understand, you know? It's not only asking question. Just using what as an interrogative, but other things are also important. So if you get stuck somewhere, just remember this 6 wives and 1 husband. So you ask questions. So question has to be, you cannot ask somebody to tell me what could be a question, but you have to generate that question, right? Then only the understanding is there. So actually this is the title, and I was scared to put this title on the front. It is Universal Paradox, Circular Oscillating Self-Referential. So take an example, x square plus 1 equals 0, x equals minus 1 by x. So if you want to put a value of x as 1, and then you want to know what is the value of x, you get minus 1. So it's like a paradox. Okay. So it's like, what you say, I, imaginary. So it's circular, okay, the never stable, it goes from minus 1 to 1, it keeps on oscillating. Okay, you will not find this concept, you will find it in one of the books which is mentioned in the references. And he considered Boolean algebra is actually not an algebra, in that, you know, wherein he tried to give a lot of supporting reasons, saying that Boolean algebra is actually not an algebra. And and you have, I mean, these are just included for, you know, for us to remember. So if I say I is imaginary with respect to real values, right, then phi and not of phi is also imaginary with true knowledge. So if I have knowledge phi, I can also say not of phi, not of phi, not having that knowledge. Okay, which can complete my knowledge, because it's like P versus NP. Does it mean that you know P then you know NP? Or do you feel that if you know NP, you know it is something is P? Right? So that's how we learn. We learn, we slowly, slowly we segregate. So we are trying, you know, we are trying to solve, I mean people are trying to solve P versus NP problem. Why they are trying to solve that problem? Okay, so if you know something is P, then you know something is else is NP. Right? Actually a mother theory CS. Which, I mean, it cannot exist actually. Phi and not of phi cannot exist at the same time. Actually, it's just a formal way of declaration. So, paradoxes are important. In fact, but you know, when something is contradicting, we don't feel it good. But if you talk about poems, lot of contradiction, and through those contradictory sentences, you know. Poems have become so widely world known, the people use them all the time, right? Right? So you can see this, our sweetest songs are those that tell of saddest thought. Can it happen? I come back to where I have never been. Can it happen? Cannot happen, right? So in that context, actually our mind feels very happy when there is some contradiction, I think, something like that. Are you happy when after reading this? Right? So what we have to do, we have to come out from this happiness, you know. If you have to be happy, then you will not be able to ask questions. You have to come out from that. So we are not evolved programmatically or whatever. So we are, lot of paradoxes around. Some people tell us something, some people tell us something. We take it. Okay, we change our thinking, we change our, you know, the definition of a particular concept, or keep on changing, you know, it's always evolving. It's not the same. I think 5 years back, probably what you had thought of programming is not the same now. So it's changing, you know, even after 10 years, 20 years, it will change. So, but then you cannot change so much that programming does not become, should not become non-programming, right? Hard to change paradigms around. So we have to understand the 6 W's and one plus one. So how do we do this? I mean, it's not that easy. You know, you have to keep on asking questions. Sometimes you get bored because you're not used to asking questions, right? Sometimes you may find you may have to write something, but you're not used to writing anything. So, but then the simplest way to do it is write some sentences and then keep on asking questions, and that's how it becomes bigger and bigger. So, right? So it's nothing different than doing, you know, M.Tech thesis or your PhD thesis, because you have to keep on asking questions, right? You have to get answers for that. So answering is not important. Questioning is important, actually. If you don't get an answer to your question, you should not be sad, you know, you should be much happier, because you have a chance to find an answer to that question. So you keep on asking that question. And I'm not saying asking question everybody, but ask to yourself. Right? So that will be a curiosity there. So then you keep on searching answer to that question. Okay, so answering is not important. Otherwise you are like a machine. Ask a question, give me an answer. The IQ is very high. Very high IQ is also not important, right? You know that. So, Rudyard Kipling says, I keep 6 honest serving men. They taught me all I knew. Their names are what and why and when and how and where and who. Okay, this is mine. So you need 6 W's and 1 H along with their complements, not just the what, but not what, or not why. Okay. Six W's. Not correct?
I W's.
No.
There are six there, five.
Down there are five, down there is five.
No. This slide you only mentioned five, one is lost.
Six.
Oh, on the top, which is lost?
Oh, you are talking about the Rudyard Kipling?
Yes.
Oh, I don't know why you did not consider one of them.
Which?
So which is lost, yeah. Which is
lost? Ask your question, which is lost, I don't know.
Which is lost? Question and the answer is the same.
Isn't that a paradox?
It is a, yeah.
The question is equal to the answer.
So when paradoxes happen, people like it, you know. So everybody so happy. Okay. So this is a, I tried to put it as a one-day cycle, but it could be 2 days, 3 days also. So this is the knowledge that you have or you're trying to gain. So everywhere there is, if you work hard, you'll understand. And if you understand, you like it, and then you'll work hard again. People say that, some of them, they say, I don't like mathematics. It's because they don't understand mathematics. Because they have not worked hard, right? So if you work hard, you will understand. So it's like that. The cycle. Play also almost same. What if you keep on working hard, very hard, very hard? What happens to this? See, a cycle is somehow this should get completed. It has to be balanced, right? Otherwise that will be too large. And so you also learn something from here, from here, from here, right? So you have to enjoy it. Now these are, arrows are important here. If you see the arrows, they are not contradicting. In fact, if you keep on enjoying more, then this cycle, this will not run. And because this will not run, your, if you keep on working, suppose if you keep on working very hard, okay, if you keep on working very hard, there is an arrow here and arrow here, this has to revolve, right? So arrows are important. This is a typical system dynamics way of representing. So how to think critically? This is from Polya. Anybody knows Polya?
Yes.
Polya?
He was a great Russian mathematician.
Great. Why great?
So he had
many, it is written.
He had many theorems.
Which theorem? Can you name one?
Sir, I don't know exact theorems. He has written a great book, but...
You read at least?
No, I just read the name of the book.
Then how can you assume that he is great? Anyway, he has given something to us, and this is I think 1930s or quite very old, and it is still valid. Not only him, I've seen many people do consider this as a chart, you know. You can put it in your bedroom, wherever you want, you know, big screen. But it's not that you have to follow everything. You can read it, you know. So first thing is you have to understand the problem. There are some steps which are given there, right? But if you read it and if you relate it to what you are trying to solve, you will feel that you are very close to it, actually. But if you have missed out something, if you have missed out something and you just go and read this, you may find that in that. So just a reference, okay, so that needs to be, you can put it up somewhere and read something. Like a prayer, maybe for some people, not for all. So, you can read what is unknown. So there are, in a problem, you have three things. One is unknown, the data and the condition. I'll put up this slide somewhere else so that you can read it up later. Yeah. So the first is how to understand the problem. Second thing is, how do you find some sort of connection between the data and unknown? So suppose I'm trying to solve a problem, and if you feel that data is not sufficient, then I will try to reduce my data and then make it, you know, or I'll try to change my unknown in some form wherein I'll try to fit it somewhere. Okay, so some sort of a, you know, a little bit high level of, you know, I need to change something somewhere, I need to change. So you're trying to evolve, you know, all the time. And that's why you ask these questions. So, like, you know, you can ask an auxiliary problem, you know, if you want to, I want to solve P versus NP, it's not possible, so you better solve something else, no? And why you waste 100 years solving only P versus NP? You solve something else, so there are auxiliary problems available. So you slowly have some transition in different domains, slowly. Right? And of course you should need, you need a plan towards, and then you, you know, it's like, and then you need, you know, it's like a cycle actually. It's not from top to down at one go, but you have to go back actually. You have to see whether it has already really what we have reached somewhere, or what any solution that you acquired, is it really fitting back? So you have to go back. Sometimes you have to iterate in the second step also. Keep on iterating. It's like that. Okay. So these are my views. Maybe you can take it, or you don't want to take it, you can take some of the steps. Purpose and motivation. You need a purpose. You know, when you want to do something, you just don't do anything. No? Keep on doing just because you feel that people are working. I also want to work. So there must be a purpose. So some motivation. Some good motivating examples wherein you get fascinated. Like, for example, my friend, he has said, he has heard about polio, but somewhere he has stuck, you know. Like, so if we understand a little bit more about polio, maybe he would consider him as a great mathematician. Yeah. Review of the existing literature sources with proper criticism, of course, because you cannot, you should never believe in anybody. Never believe. Even if the author says that it is like this, no, I will have to prove it myself, then only I will figure out what is right and what is wrong. So what, it has to fit inside first, otherwise you will be very unhappy person. Problem identification, formulation, of course you need to identify, then only the problem. Problem means very crisp problem, not just something called as whatever, big data analytics. It's not a problem. It's a big field, right? It's not a problem. Problem has to be very crisp and solvable, actually. Putting forward specific and ambitious questions or hypotheses, any of those hypotheses. In fact, there is something on my website, so where you can go and read. I've drawn a diagram, so you may like it. If you don't like it, don't even look at it. So almost the same, you know, tackling the problem with critical analysis, giving various solutions to the problem identified, not just one solution, at least two, three if you can give. And then you choose, you know, which one was the best. Case study, of course, required. You just don't say that this system is going to work, but if there is no case study done, then you don't know whether your system is going to work, right? So then you have to demonstrate to somebody, right? Proper documentation is also required, and also future, because if you are thinking that you have built up your knowledge on somebody else's shoulders, like reading from somewhere, then it is your duty to show to others what future possibilities. So it is your duty to write there that this is the future possibilities are possible, you know, in this area. So it's your duty, and it is more than solving a problem. Then a clear-cut presentation, so that even a layman can understand. Chai wala. No hi-fi terms, analytics, data, I mean, they are very difficult to understand. Okay, these are the sources, journals, conference, proceedings, monographs, renowned books, white papers, technical standards, software documentation, even newspapers. You may find something interesting in newspaper and you want to solve it. And then this is applicable for everybody, including me. Do and I understand, then only. So these are my references. In fact, the circularity definition, if you see Art of Computer Programming by Kunut. Anybody knows Kunut?
Yes.
Can you tell me now what contribution he has done?
Sir, I mean, he has wrote a great book on algorithms. It has 3 to 4 volumes, Art of Computer Programming. And means he is known as the father of algorithm design. Means he has invented many.
Which algorithm? Which algorithm?
Sir, actually he has he had made the Big O notations and all that famous for means analyzing the algorithm.
Okay, so you read that book?
Sir, I have not read.
No.
I could not get hands on that book. Actually, I wanted.
Has anybody read that book? It is difficult. It was a Bible before when no books were available. But he defines what is called a circularity. You will be surprised how he does it. In the index, he defines some. In his book, he writes circularity. So somebody has to go in the index and find out where is it defined. Right. So there he defines C circularity. Circularity definition, sorry. And then down somewhere, CD, C circular definition. In the index, how beautifully he has put it, right? Nowhere it is mentioned, but in the index it is there. C, CD, and then CD, C circular definition. With that, I think you should understand what is circular definition. You don't need to study a proper definition to understand certain definitions, right? So these are internship projects. But not, I'm not the only person, there are other people also. So the big thing, I mean, the broader perspective, it is more about cloud, and cloud is also a jargon. You should ask me what is cloud, right? And the big data, it's more about data which is structured as well as unstructured, or any type of data that exists in the system, and what you want to do with that data. There has to be some way to analyze it, or some way wherein you can find some meaningful information from that data. So that is the whole purpose there. So there are lots of lot of efforts going in different, I mean, all over the world, and people are trying to design some standards. They have tried to design some MookDB or something like that. So they have tried to say that for this particular platform, this is a edX platform, open edX platform, partly been modified to suit the Indian requirements. And so, you know, efforts are there wherein they want to standardize on, say, even the schema, right? You know, there's no schema, first of all, so you would like to involve some schema. Okay, so there are. So you may consider it, or we also have evolved some schema. Our schema is different than the MIT schema. So you are free to consider one of them. So because you need to know which one is the best, okay, or which one is better, not best. So there are logs which are, you know, when when students actually navigate on this platform, so logs get generated. Every event is being logged, right? So what do you do with those events? Now you have to find some way out, and you have to, right? I mean, you need to know something about the student, right? Or you need to know how the course is running. And there are a lot of pictures, you know, the teacher would like to know, you know, the course, or for a particular student, or a group of students, are they performing, right? I mean, so a so lot of analysis or analytics or analysis about possible. You know, you can have a very basic analysis first, and then you can build on, abstract them out. Right, so there is an insight platform. I think, in fact, Aparna covered a section of this. EDX insight.
That eventually integrated with IIT Bombay X. That's outside the scope of this, right?
No, it needs to be integrated.
Literally, eventually, that's why I'm asking.
Right.
So eventually means before June or after June? After they leave or before they leave?
No, I think if they can provide some proof of concept for
eventually after June.
No, proof of concept.
My only concern is I am handling IIT Bombay X.
Right.
Okay. I haven't received any request from you saying that
IIT Bombay X. No. We are talking on the platform. I mean, just if they are able to show me on Open at X code,
right.
That is fine. Yeah.
I don't want any impact.
Not that.
Which is not. Governed by me.
Right. Yeah.
Industry speaking.
So your data will be safe.
Then I will be interested in what you are doing. Coming inside.
Of course, I will never touch your system.
I don't
know. Keep your system somewhere. Experiment somewhere else.
The rest of the MIS is coming in, definitely.
Yeah.
That is certain.
So there are some basic some information. It's like, for example, how many males or how many females, you know, such type of demographic information, or you know, like how many students have answered this quiz correctly or that quiz correctly, whatever. It's very basic information there. But there are some interesting questions which we can ask, like how many students have never viewed learning resource A. So it's also possible to ask. If you want to know how many students have actually viewed that resource, it's possible to say the opposite way. So if a student do well on activity B, so they do well on activity C, is it so? Then you can see if this is true, then you say something, right? And if this is true, then you can say something. So we don't know what is that. I mean, you can think, what is that? If they solve exercise D, do they also solve exercise E? They may be related, you know, interrelated. So maybe quite very similar exercises. So if they solve this, they are able to solve that. So these are, I mean, some questions which you can put forward. There are some 30-40 questions written down also. We'll provide you that. Yeah. See which courses have you learned a lot of learning resources and which of the questions please are not answered correctly at all. So they can tell the teacher in some way that, you know, this quiz was very bad, so do I need to put up another quiz? Or maybe the particular concept is not understood properly, or a set of concepts, 2, 3, or there is a dependency between this and this, so if they have not understood this, then they have also not understood this. Right? So it's a way you can identify some relationship between, you know, entities and then come with an outcome saying that okay, then the teacher has to decide, you know, what to do with it. Okay. You cannot tell the teacher that, you have to give a new quiz. My system says that this is my information and my system says that you should give a new quiz. But that's not correct. So teacher has to analyze too. System will tell you some analysis here and there. So these are some of the questions. So you can think.
I will just skip it. New quiz is Dr. Khattar's special requirement. Okay. Because if he finds the quiz people have failed, he now dilutes it and gives a new quiz so that people will pass. Yes, he does it all the time. That is called makeup.
Makeup. You always has got makeup.
Makeup test.
So everybody makes up towards the end. You can also find the time required to solve a particular question. You know, a lot of questions. So many questions should come in your mind. The first day of your internship, I don't know, not today, maybe when if I find that particular group, that group has to write at least 200 questions. Is it okay? So this is, you know, OpenStack is one thing that where we are trying, because the whole cloud today that we have, cloud is something where the bunch of VMs, virtual machines, okay, or some where there is a platform, okay, where a particular environment is there, and in that environment you have bunch of VMs, virtual machines. Instead of say physical machine, I can say 10 number of virtual machines in my system. I can have 10 VMs inside this. Yeah. In this system, I can have 10 VMs, 20 VMs. I should be able to configure it. Okay. Instead of running it on this machine, or instead of running on the whole machine, I want to run, say for example, this software on one VM. So I should be able to configure, you know, all of those requirements. I need this much memory for this process. I need this much memory for hard disk space, or you know, some you know, this much storage should be attached to this VM. And all everything virtual. Right. So the cloud OpenStack is one product which allows you to do that. Sorry. Oh, is it? Oh, so I made a mistake. I did everything in the morning. He says the description is the same of the previous project actually. Oh, it happens sometimes.
But the project is different, no?
Project is different. name is there.
And the number of interns is 8.
Number of interns is 8, that is correct. I should be correct somewhere, no? No, it should be 4, I think.
Correct.
So
this is 4. Yeah. So on the net, it is correct.
Oh, it's 4. And then I have everything somewhere. Yeah.
Whatever is there on the net is there.
Yeah. Ah, whatever is there on the net. On your... Okay, let me not waste time.
Yeah.
Just to, whatever I keep on forgetting, so a lot of other things also exist. Also OpenStack, you have a lot of other peripheral, you know, elements available where you can have your separate storage, and you know, you can configure it as you want. So it's a very large project product. We have not used it to that extent. And we would like a present cloud that we have is actually put on VMware instead of OpenStack. So we would like to have the whole platform using OpenStack, and then, as a proof of concept, we would have to demonstrate either EDX or any of those, because we already have specification, or you know, some minimal specification for the EDX platform deployment. So those you can consider, and so some machines would be given to you, of course. Then so as you can see, Swift is one where we are interested, because the EDX Open EDX platform actually connects to S3 services, and if you don't want, you can always stop those services. But what happens is that you don't want the data to exist on this server. You would like the data to exist on storage clusters or separate clusters, where you can manage separately rather than putting everything at one place. Okay, that's what, so then it becomes highly scalable, because you're not loading a particular machine. You need to, the cloud will take care of all those. So performance is one thing which is sometimes very important, because you may feel that you have a product today which is running, you will feel that it will support even 5 million students or 10 million students. But then it may not scale to that level. So what do you do? So you have to actually test out something. Is it possible that, I mean, do we need little, I mean, better hardware, or do we need more clusters? So what is a solution? So that solution we need to find out. You cannot say that my system will scale to 1 million, 2 million, just like that. And there must be some, there should be some test results. And saying that I have simulated it in some way or the other. Okay, so at least an experiment is performed, and I feel that it can hold to this response level or whatever. So we use the J-meter here. Load runner is also being used. You may also need to consider workload behavior. These are just an extension to what is, what when you talk about performance issues, what do you want to really see? Okay, so is there a uniform access or skewed access to certain hardware, certain disks which are there? So you would like to find some problem first, right? And then you want to solve that. Right, so you need to probe into something, right? I'm just giving you some very broad overview. Okay. So is there some variations over time? Okay, so is a cluster, suddenly is there an unpredictable load somewhere, and is there a problem? So where maybe the afternoon at from 12 to 2 when everybody watching movies, this happens, right? Do you know when is the peak load? We need to find certain large bus in the workload. So you can also find what type of workload is it? Is it just a video access, right? Or is it just you from the data actually you can actually figure out how much video has been used, how much slides have been used, or how much problem solving or quizzes, So what is, So you have a fair distribution once you know your data. Data is there, so you can extract this information. So there are some benchmarks available, already available. So I put it, some references are there. And they have actually tried to use it like TPCH type of benchmarks, which is generally used in for benchmarking OLTP systems, or no, this is a decision support system. They really use wherein you would like to know how much of processing power can it have. So is my hardware capable of doing that? Right, so yeah, it has been built on already existing benchmarks, and
so I've given in the references. There's a book also available. You can read
a whole lot.
So here,
if you're talking about Hadoop, when you say you have, so you saw that architecture, right, in the beginning, that big architecture. So that architecture, whatever, if you say the platform does not include what you say Hadoop and all those activities. It's not there, right? So your platform is separate. And anyway, if you want to do analytics, and the basic analytics which is there in EDX does not use Hadoop at all. And there is some elastic search which is there, and bunch of, which I don't know, but they don't use Hadoop. Now if you want to put Hadoop for this, can you do real time or near real time analytics and give some information to the teacher? Like, you are surprised suddenly, right? When you are on Gmail, it suddenly pops up and tells you that do you like this? But how does it know? It tries to find some whatever you have searched before. And
I have a question.
Yeah.
Why is real time information required in the MOOC scenario?
It may not be required.
It is not required.
It is not required.
Sorry. Real time.
I don't know. I
human instance.
Yeah. So
the whole purpose of MOOC is there are so many people all over the world. they are being given one week.
Okay, suppose
to do whatever they want.
Suppose I find that people are answering questions now, right now, and there is a deadline which stops in another 1 second or 1 minute. And if I know that I they are answering, I would like to extend the time. It's possible. I would like to extend another 1 hour for them. If they are answering now, I would like to do that.
I don't understand. You have given them 1 week.
I given
they
them
want 100. To do, instead of 7 days, they want to do in the last 7 minutes.
Generally, it so happens that people answer towards the end only.
Okay.
Right. Now the time saying that one hour is there, they will do something. But if I find they are not able to solve, can I estimate how much time they will take?
No.
Why not?
No.
Can I estimate?
Yes, there are issues there. No, I have faced it where I ran that quiz.
Yeah.
Okay.
Those are
now tell
quizzes.
Me, you extended.
Yeah.
Isn't it unfair to the people who answered?
No. It is not.
How
unfair.
It is not unfair?
Because this is.
I was not sure I did it because the time limit was there. Now you are extending it. It is unfair.
Yeah. So then
you
can't. Are,
it's
okay.
Very simple.
So,
I have been a sportsman.
Okay.
You
so,
can't change the rules in the world of a game.
Okay. So you may change.
Based
change
on Achanchalo. Chennai Super Kings is losing.
No.
Let us instead of Duckworth Lewis, we'll use that system.
Wait. You change the time and then you don't consider them as marks. You don't show them that I have changed. But you change it so that you get some information about them, that they have taken this much amount to solve this. At least they are understanding you here to know.
I don't think real time is required.
So real time is you would not need, because unless until the stock market something happening, I mean you would need, otherwise you don't need. So even if you have
real time or Dr. Fata's requirement from a clicker system,
right,
which is completely different.
Right.
Okay.
Yes.
I answer a question in a class, physical class.
Right.
Depending on the answer, I should do my explanation.
Of course.
There is a real time requirement.
Yeah.
I agree.
Right.
But not here. Don't extend the requirements of the earlier system to a new system.
Mm-hmm.
It is completely new. It has nothing to do with classroom. Anything that is classroom requirement doesn't go into MOOC. Two different ways of educating.
So this is another fourth project. It's about replicating. I don't know. In fact, Professor Patak wrote this. And I just put it up here. So did anybody understand this? And can we have a discussion? And I'm ready to answer any of the questions.
No, I know what it is. What is the problem? The distributed database, a real time sync.
Right.
This
so
is in sync with this blended model.
Oh,
okay.
That is in relation to blended.
Correct.
Okay. So
I keep saying, Dr. Patak is not mad.
Yes.
Okay.
So somewhere.
Okay. It is relationship with something else.
Yeah.
The blended model earlier had a lot of servers, okay, and the data had to be synced. Okay. And the reason why he is putting it up is when we did the implementation, I told him very flatly that I will not do real time. Okay. I will do in a batch. Because I come from that fundamental thing that real time is not required in those. Okay. So whatever I had implemented, tried to implement, not implemented completely, was a batch. Okay.
Right.
So that's why he wants a real-time system implemented for a distributed database, which he can use in the future.
So there is a main system, and there is other systems which are connected. Maybe
the main type was the concept which we are trying to implement was. The whole data is put in by an IIT professor or some professor, central professor who is delivering the MOOC. Okay. The same copy is there in every college. Okay. Same copy of the course. The college faculty can add to it. Okay. His own lectures, his own quizzes, etc. That's why it is a copy. Now, college A, whatever is added, is college A proprietary. I cannot share it with college B, nor can I share it with this thing. So the concept was there were different sets of data available everywhere, okay. But the central faculty has to know what is happening in local colleges. The data has to be synced. It's a pair, multiple pair kind of thing. It's not full network. Okay? Because I had implemented it here. I know what is not. And I said no.
So something happens on one side, you have the instructor maintaining the whole platform itself for that course. Those many lectures, whatever he puts up, it has to be synced somewhere. And then some discussions happening from the other side. Maybe you would like to sync it on the other side.
That was his requirement, I said no. No, I hold it.
Yeah.
This college is charging money for training its students. Mm. You may have your Umunga water idealistic system. Okay, but the world works on money.
Right.
This college will not agree that whatever money it has spent or effort it has spent should be available to its competitor. Academic nahi hai abhi, the businesses hai. All colleges run on business. So the system has to be designed like that. Opaque, not.
Yeah, but there are people like DBP who does not like business.
Yeah, I know.
I mean, he has a strong no-no to businesses.
But he is dealing with businessmen now who is selling education.
Yeah, he deals with businessmen to get funding.
You want them to absorb this.
Yeah.
I have been trying to tell him that this particular model he has to charge the colleges. He doesn't listen. I can't help him. I am against all college managers.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so
they charge too much, deliver nothing.
Yeah. You give them too much and they don't give anything. Okay. So the fifth project between Moodle and edX in IIT Bombay. So not your IIT, the IIT Bombay X, the edX, Open edX.
You can do it from IIT Bombay X, I have no problem.
That will
do. You should do it IIT Bombay.
Yeah.
After I have delivered the software to the system administration to run, I have said 100 times, the production system maintenance is outside my group. Okay, so you can add features to it independently, I have no problem. Don't come to me to add anything, change.
No.
I will give you blended, I will give you translation. These are my two forms.
Translation?
Translation manager is included.
What translation?
Of the course.
Course.
That's what she said. No, two activities we are working on. Translatability of all course content
automatic,
as well as the blended
model. Automatic translatability or what?
If you want, I will give you automated AI. I have done it in Ekashiksha. I have no problem.
That is Google.
Tell me.
Thing.
And for this particular purpose, I can do it officially also. Because Google, for educational purposes, Google gives the API free. For my purposes, I cheat. I thank them and cheat.
So you
Rekha Shiksha has translated Google and I thank them officially, okay, for making their free source available. Actually, my earlier thank I changed. I said, I thank you officially for making it available without adding a capture. If you want to protect it, add a capture. Everybody knows that. Okay. If you don't add a capture, I will cheat. And Google can't claim they don't know capture technology. So it's obvious they want me to cheat. So darwaja khula chhodta hai, abhi mat bolo cheating kiya yaar. Bolo mat chhodo na, tumko maloom hai ek lock aaya capture.
Where is that R? Somebody found an R somewhere.
No, R is going to come in later on. R is being called. But that is only one project. She will not get too many people. Okay.
So R is just a statistical package.
No, I don't. You are not doing R now. You are doing Q. Checking. So you stop. Yeah. The R person, because of public demand, is going to come and talk about R.
So who is that R?
Professor
Nag. Oh, now I got it.
So you don't have to talk. I'll ask her to come here.
Fine. Okay. So I finished my talk here.
Yeah.
One, you can go through my slides later. Okay.
Yeah,
more details will be provided. So I'm putting up it here.
This will show.
Okay, so that is it.
Last year we used this for all project descriptions.
Which one?
Your wiki.
That is brainstorming.
Something you have done.
Yeah.
So that was better. Aajkal ye nahi
ki. Oh, this time we have not done.
We did not have time. We finished the project descriptions only very late.
Right.
I told him we were busy with a lot of other things.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so that's the link and the define. So in fact, it is still under construction. Last year, at least, I had 400 to 500 references. This time, I have less.
So the hardware guy is coming with his own hardware.
Yes.